Yo, what is going on, guys? Nico back here with another Madden video, and in today's video, I'm going to be going over the new flashbacks that are in the game. We have five new ones, going over their stats and how good the cards are and what kind of significance they have. So we're going to go over that. Also, I should be getting Auction House unbanned today, so that's a good thing. It should be around 1 to 2 p.m. Eastern, hopefully, I'm guessing, because that's when I got banned last week. So if you guys enjoy the video, make sure to leave a like and hit the subscribe button. Also, comment down below what videos you guys want to see the rest of the week, and make sure to turn the bell on so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. So let's get right into these. All right, guys. The first card we have here at a 90 overall is AJ Boye. Now, he is a good card, but if his price comes down a little bit, he would be a really good budget option. If his price comes down to like 120, I don't think it will because of training value, but he's 88 speed, 90 excel, 87 agility, 87 change direction, 88 awareness, 90 jumping, 88 play rec. He has 87 man, 90 zone, and 85 press. Really, really, really good, really well-balanced corner. He has good pursuit. His tackling's low, block shed's low. He's not physical. He's more of a zone corner. If his price comes down more, I would recommend picking this card up. He's 6 foot, so he's not short. And, yeah, I really do like this card. Actually, his correlates went up a little bit in price, like 18K now. We go down here to abilities. He gets all the ones you really want. Acrobat, mid-zone. If you guys run man, like, if you play on old gen, then, like, bench press. Or he doesn't get one step ahead, actually. So, I'm not sure if you need, like, 90 man to get to that. I'm not really sure. But he does get mid-zone, acrobat, and, you know, bench press and some other stuff here. He gets acrobat and, in his second tier. Very, very, very balanced card for AJ Boye here. I usually like how he plays. I had him in Madden 19, one of his cards, and I really enjoyed it. So, I mean, he probably plays well, but me having a theme team, I'm not going to pick him up. So, let's get into the next flashback. All right, guys, coming in here is CJ Mosley. Now, we do get a Raven, and you know, that's going to help my team out, obviously. He's an unusable card, absolutely unusable. He's way too slow. He's a linebacker, and he doesn't get lurker, so he might in his tier 3. No, he doesn't. Wait, that's his ability slot too. All right, so if we go over here to his power him all the way up, he still doesn't get lurker. All right, so CJ Mosley doesn't get lurker here, but he has 83 speed. Hang on, let's go back. He has 83 speed, 87 excel, 85 agility, 76 change direction, which is just horrible. 87 awareness, 80 strength, 85 jump, 87 play rec. He's not a pass rusher. He has 61 finesse move, 70 power move. Tackling's good, hit power's good, pursuit's good, block shed's good. And is that someone needs to let me know what that is down in the comment. I would know what it is when I hear it. I just don't know the abbreviation. But he's a good physical guy for the run. He is just too slow though. So like on my team or Jets teams, he'll be an 80 six speed guy. But he's just too slow for like a common team. And 86 speed still isn't too good. So he's really just for the run. Like if you're facing a guy with like Derrick Henry or Sean Alexander just running the ball over and over again, maybe you sub him in. But other than that, I just don't see how this card is good. And let's get into the next flashback. All right, guys, coming in here, we have Ryan Tannehill, which I do believe, I'm not sure. So if we come over here to power up, and if we power him up all the way, I don't know. I think he might get Gunslinger. He doesn't get Gunslinger. All right, so Ryan Tannehill, that's a little disappointing there. But his 83 is 83 speed, 87 excel, 81 agility, 86 awareness, 89 throw power, 86 short, 87 medium, 86 deep, 86 throw on the run, 86 throw under pressure, and 88 play action. It's decent. I mean, he has decent accuracies all across the board, and his speed's decent. He just doesn't get he does get Cephili, which is good right here. But, I mean, Gunslinger, Zach Wilson's just better, in my opinion. This card really shouldn't be on anyone's team unless you're running Titans or Dolphins teams. So, Tannehill's decent. He's all-around decent quarterback. He's like a slower version of Daniel Jones, in my opinion. That's Ryan Tannehill. Let's get into the next guy. All right, guys. Coming in here is Micah Hyde. Now, way too slow. I'm just going to come out and say it. They always give Micah Hyde, make him so slow. He has 87 speed, 89 excel, 86 agility, 85 change of direction, 87 awareness, 85 jumping, 87 play rec, 84 man, and 91 zone. So, obviously, the zone is what they do every year, is the high part. He has 80 tackling and 88 pursuit. He actually has high hit power for a Micah Hyde card. He's like 97 last year, like 52 hit power. It was disgusting. But I would not use this card unless you're rocking a Bills or Packers theme team. He has 87 speed. He's not going to cut it, especially with Team Diamonds coming out on Friday. So Micah Hyde, just not a good card in my opinion. So let's get into the last one. All right, guys, and the last one is Cam Newton. Now, he can get Escape Artist when powered all the way up, but he doesn't get Cephili, Gunslinger, or any of that, which makes his card really not usable. He's going to be like Vince. I mean, Vince Young's not bad. You really need to be using Gunslinger, Cephili, or one of the two, and Cam Newton doesn't get either, and he's slower than Vince Young, and he's got worse accuracy. So 86 speed, 90 excel is good on a quarterback. I'm really shocked that he has the same speed as Daniel Jones. That really doesn't make sense. But he has 91 throw power, which is good. 86 short, 84 medium, which you wish was higher. 87 deep, 88 throw on the run, 81 throw under pressure, and 88 play action. And he's an 82 break sack, which is pretty high. His carrying is an 84. His ball carrier vision's a 90. Juke moves 84. Spin moves 80. Trucking's an 88, which don't do it. Just don't. Just please don't get Cam Newton and try to truck people over. It won't work. He's 6'5". He's a big build. I really would only get this card if you have a Panthers or Patriots team. That's really the only thing. And Patriots teams, I don't even know if I would switch from... I'm guessing Brady's your quarterback now. And he has seven... I mean, maybe I would switch because Brady's just too immobile. But Panthers, obviously, you probably get Cam Newton here. So that's Cam Newton. I think he's just not really the meta right now, which is a gunslinger except the elite quarterback. I think the flashbacks from last time were better than the flashbacks from this time. Especially Daniel Jones is still better than Cam Newton, in my opinion. Those are the flashbacks, and let's get into the outro. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching the video. If you enjoyed, make sure to leave a like, hit the subscribe button, comment down below, and turn the bell on so you get notified whenever I upload. This morning's video is going to be the flashback one, and then later this afternoon's video, I'm gonna have to look at what I'm going to do. Maybe I'll do like a lineup update because I've had some pretty big upgrades over the past week. So maybe I'll do that because I haven't done one. But I mean, if you watch my video of my weekend league update, you saw my lineup. So I mean, I'll decide. Maybe I'll do I could try to record a gameplay. I'll try to figure it out. I've been a little like weird with doing the gameplay because I'm not sure how to edit that after. So I'm still figuring that out. But if you guys enjoyed the video, leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. See ya.